That's a biryani that punches you with its spicy fervor the moment you place it in your mouth. I can definitely taste that green chili punch. You're tasting the freshness of those ingredients juxtaposed against the meaty, deep flavors of the liver. It has a fragment of a bite before it yields to your taste buds. When you haven't met somebody in ages and you see that person, and you don't just see that person, but you embrace that person with all your love, with all your heart. That's the feeling that I'm experiencing now as I taste this mutton dhone biryani after months, nearly a year. Hi folks, this is Kripal Amana, Gourmet on the Road, and you're watching Food Lovers TV. I hope you're doing well. It's a cold and rainy afternoon here in Bengaluru, and I'm in the mood to taste some hot biryani, some busy biryani. And not just any biryani, but a local favorite, that is the Donne biryani. And not just any Donne biryani, but the Donne biryani at Shivaji Military Hotel. It's been a very long time since I've tasted the Shivaji Military Hotel Donne biryani at the eatery itself, and I've been craving that for a while. Those who watch Food Lovers TV regularly will know that we featured Shivaji Military Hotel in the past. Our first episode, which was over a year and a half ago, we looked at the making of their mutton biryani. The last episode, I think about 7 or 8 months ago, we looked at the making of the chicken biryani and also some breakfast items at Shivaji Military Hotel. The other aspect to tasting the biryani at Shivaji Military Hotel today is to also find out how they are doing. So post-lockdown, the rest of the world opened, restaurants opened for takeaways first, and then restaurants have been operating dine-in for many months now. But Shivaji Military Hotel chose to take the conservative approach. Because of the number of customers that used to throng the place, they decided not to reopen for dine-in till they were completely comfortable. So for the last few months, it's only been takeaway biryanis, and they've just opened a week or two ago for customers to dine in at the eatery. So I'm quite curious to see how things have changed at Shivaji Military Hotel, and of course, most importantly, to relish some busy Donne biryani. Well, here we are at Shivaji. It's 12:30. There seems to be nobody out here except for the solitary guard. Open it, na? I've never seen things so quiet here. I can smell fresh paint, so I think they've also utilized this time to spruce up the premises. Namaskar, aayegi tera? Samit, Rajiv and Lokesh, the brothers behind Shivaji Military Hotel. Everybody knows them. Aayegi situation idha
iga, Rajiv? Sir, it's quite paravagila. Normal bartha ide.
Bartha ide?
Bartha ide. Ik inna last week start maadi varnavu.
Okay. You sumar time you start maadilla?
Start maadilla.
Yaake?
Naavu safe aagirbeku, public safe aagirbeku. Adrinda ಸ್ವಲ್ಪ ಟೈಮ್ ತಗೊಂಡು ನಿಧಾನಕ್ಕೆ ನಾವು ಸ್ಟೇಟ್ಮೆಂಟ್ ಹೇಗಿದೆ ಅದು ನೋಡ್ಕೊಂಡು ಮಾಡಿ.
ಬರೀ ಟೇಕ್ ಅವೇ ಇತ್ತು?
ಬರೀ ಟೇಕ್ ಅವೇ ಇತ್ತು.
ಅಂದ್ರೆ ನಿಮ್ದು ಬಿಸ್ನೆಸ್ ಬಹಳ ಇಂಪ್ಯಾಕ್ಟ್ ಆಗಿರ್ಬೋದು. ಬಟ್ ಸ್ಟಿಲ್ ನೀವು ಅದು ಚಾಯ್ಸ್ ತಗೊಂಡ್ರಿ?
ಹೌದು ಹೌದು. ಫಸ್ಟ್ ಒಂದು ಬಂದಾಗಿಂದ ಸ್ವಲ್ಪ ಕಮ್ಮಿನೇ ಇತ್ತು, ಈಗ ಸ್ವಲ್ಪ ಹಂಗ ಜನ ಸರ್ವಿಸ್ ಬಿಟ್ಮೇಲೆ ಸ್ವಲ್ಪ ಬರಕ್ ಸ್ಟಾರ್ಟ್ ಆಗಿದ್ದಾರೆ.
And even though dine-in was permitted, they took a decision not to reopen just so that they could be safe and people here could be safe. Also, given the fact that at Shivaji Military Hotel, you always have hordes of people lining up for that biryani. Bari half way open
maadi dara.
Okay. So, generally control maadthira nivu kelige ella?
Generally, avaru bitidivi. Illi eshtu jana idare ashtu jana idu maadkondo. ಖಾಲಿ ಆಗ್ತಾರೆ ಅಷ್ಟು ಜನ ಮೇಲ್ಗಡೆ ಕಳಿಸ್ತೀವಿ.
ಸೊ ಇದು ಇವರು ಹೋದ ಮೇಲೆ ಬೇರೆ ಬರ್ಬೋದು. ಸೊ ಮುಂಚೆ ತರ ಪೀಪಲ್ ವೇ ಸ್ಟ್ಯಾಂಡಿಂಗ್ ಆ ತರ ಇಲ್ಲ. ಓಕೆ. ಸೊ ಅರ್ಲಿ ಅಟ್ ಶಿವಾಜಿ ಮಿಲಿಟರಿ ಹೋಟೆಲ್ ಇಫ್ ಯು ಕೇಮ್ ಯುವರ್ ಅಂಡ್ ಇಫ್ ಯು ವೇ ಈಟಿಂಗ್ ಅ ಬಿರಿಯಾನಿ ದೇ ವೇ ಪೀಪಲ್ ಆಲ್ರೆಡಿ ಅಟ್ ಯುವರ್ ಟೇಬಲ್ ವೇಟಿಂಗ್ ಫಾರ್ ಯುವರ್ spot at the table, but now that's not happening.
No.
So when they finish, then the next lot comes. Okay.
So ellaru mask with mask sanitizer.
Okay.
Ellaru corona check maarsi.
Everybody has been checked already. Everybody in Shivaji Military Hotel is COVID negative.
Yeah.
Okay. Nodabada.
Nodi.
So I can see the biryani decks are already open. So the mutton biryani there and the chicken biryani here.
Mutton liver, mutton dry.
Oh, I like that nalli there in that.
Chili chicken.
It's been ages since I've tasted all these dishes. So you are happy that you open again?
I am happy.
And the donya biryani taste, so the same. ಸ್ವಲ್ಪ ಡಿಫ್ರೆನ್ಸ್ ಇರುತ್ತೆ.
ಕುತ್ಕೊಂಡು ತಿನ್ನಕ್ಕೆ ಫೀಲ್ ಬೇರೆ ಡಿಫ್ರೆನ್ಸ್. ಹಾಟ್ ಸಿಗುತ್ತೆ ಅಲ್ಲಿ.
When you get your hot, busy biryani coming straight out of that deg, ladled onto that donne, the flavor, the feeling is entirely different. You pack madvaga donne kodta irlilla la.
Pack madha donne kodta.
So when it's packed in the foil, but when you have it here, busy biryani, it comes in the donne. So when that hot biryani falls on that donne also lends its aroma, its fragrance to that biryani. And I think that's what you really miss when you don't eat a Shivaji Military Hotel Donne Biryani at the establishment. On that note, let's go to the restaurant and taste some Donne Biryani. What are you doing here? Donne Biryani taste? What are you
doing here? Mutton tode chanagi ide. Chicken nu taste padi. Mutton dry, liver, chili chicken.
Fantastic. So we already know the five dishes that we're going to be tasting here at Shivaji. Well, I've never seen Shivaji Military Hotel so orderly, and when I say orderly, I mean in a relative sense. If you've looked at some of our earlier videos on Shivaji Military Hotel, you'll see a sea of humanity. But out here, although every seat is taken at every table, it still is perhaps not even 40% of what the actual crowd at Shivaji Military Hotel typically is. And what's also nice is that you have people waiting on the sidelines, waiting for people to finish before they get a seat at the table. I'm sure the leaf is clean, but nothing like making contact with that leaf even before your food finds its way onto it. That's the kal soup. Mutton donne biryani, this is the chicken donne biryani. Chili chicken, mutton fry, and that's the liver. Well, that's plenty of food on the table here, and to be honest, I'm looking forward to tasting the Donne Biryani. Of course, we've tasted all these other dishes in earlier episodes of Gourmet on the Road here at Shivaji Military Hotel, but the last episode was about 8 or 10 months ago. So we'll probably spend some time on the other dishes, but I think we'll spend most of the time on the biryanis. So out here you have that kal soup, that leg soup with the trotters. We've tasted it in our last breakfast episode, and the combination with this is the dosa. They do a kali dosa out here, and that's the combination. And then you have that mutton dry. There is also a mutton liver here. And this, of course, is the Nati style, the military style chili chicken. I think what we will do is make a quick beginning with that kal soup. There's a warming, gently spiced mutton bone broth. I'm just getting off my intermittent fast with this meal, and I think there's something really nutritious about tasting the nourishment of this meaty broth. Time to tuck into that trotter. That trotter is like jelly. You don't need to work your teeth at all. The gelatin in this trotter is a sort that quite simply dissolves on your palate. Karagi ho gaya. You know, there are many of you who say that I don't like trotters, because many a times when I'm tasting all these meaty dishes, I want to get to the main part. I want to get to the meat, I want to get to the biryani, I want to get to the chops. So therefore, sometimes I tend to overlook the paya, the trotter. But I believe that all the nourishment of that trotter is already in that broth. And when I taste that, I'm already tasting that lip-smacking gelatin goodness of that trotter. And this trotter is clean very well. There's none of that funky gaminess that you will otherwise find in trotters if it's not been boiled well. Delicious. I think next I'm going to go for that biryani. We'll begin with the chicken donne biryani. This is of course made with broiler. I think they do the nati koli biryani even sometimes. But today we are having the donne biryani made with some broiler chicken. That biryani is steaming away. This is just the perfect weather, slightly cold, with some shahs to indulge in some busy biryani. And that donne has softened with the heat of that biryani. And that also releases some of its aroma, some of its fragrance, some of its character that it shares with that biryani. So when you taste the donne biryani, and if the donne biryani comes off a foil pack, you're not really tasting the same flavors. I think the best flavors of the donne biryani is when the biryani, when that busy biryani is ladled on that donne. That's a biryani that punches you with its spicy fervor the moment you place it in your mouth. I can definitely taste that green chili punch and some of the other greens, the coriander. There's also a hint of mint, but it's a green chili that leaves most impact, and that's something that you're tasting at the tip of your tongue. Oh, that's a flavorful biryani. That rice has soaked up the flavor of the spices in that biryani really well. And I'm so happy tasting this donne biryani after months. I came in the middle once when Rajiv asked me to take the donne biryani parcel. But the flavor of donne biryani, donne na tinwaga awa gaye the.
Same.
And that's what I'm really relishing today. The flavor of that donne biryani sitting here at Shivaji Military Hotel. Is this how many years Shivaji Military Hotel?
85-90 years.
So I think the energy of the place where this biryani is cooked for 85-90 years, I think also lends to that biryani. Fantastic. You Nati Koli biryani yoga martira?
Thursdays.
So if you come on a Thursday, you'll get the country chicken biryani. I've tasted it only once, but then they make it only once a week. So if you want the country chicken biryani, come here on a Thursday.
Compared to other biryanis in this
area. I've been waiting for this biryani. Biryani service yoga shuru martira. Adhe nimge helbeku. The fact that you have all these people waiting here,
yeah,
is for this.
Yeah.
And I think what really makes an impact is that secret masala.
Namma homely made alla.
Homely made. And that's the masala that they only make at home.
Masala adu yav yav beku naalege. Ivadella ready madustivi namu. Tomorrow what they have, today we'll make ready.
So the spice that I've tasted on my palate is that green chili spice, and then also the warmth that comes from the masala.
Yeah.
That's the aromatic warmth that wafts through your mouth as you're tasting that biryani.
The weather condition cold, right?
You prepare
chili.
Solpa nose nalli solpa neer barbeku. Avaga we were just discussing, only when your sinuses flare up, only when your nose moistens, that shows that you're enjoying the spice of that biryani. I think let's now taste that biryani rice with some of that meat. Well, I've tasted many a biryanis, many a donne biryanis, but I think the biryani here has a unique flavor and aroma, thereby lending to its very distinct character. So there's a fair bit of balance in the ingredients that go into the making of this biryani. And I think the reason why this biryani has been consistently popular is because the brothers, both Lokesh and Rajiv, are involved in each and every aspect of the biryani making. Sure, they have their staff, they have their team, but when it comes to the critical steps of the biryani, whether it's making that spice mix at home, whether it's sauteing the spices in that oil, giving ugarne to the biryani right at the beginning, all the steps that go in right after that, including the fistfuls of masala, the fistfuls of spice powder that they add to the biryani, it's their alte, it's their measure. And I think that lends its character to that biryani, which makes it quite unique. I think today is going to be a day dedicated to the biryani here. The rice is also soft, and it's a sort that yields quite gently to the bite. And when it comes to tasting the dhoni biryani, you have to taste the meat with some rice. Because the meat by itself doesn't have too much flavor. It's cooked well, but then it needs to draw the flavor from the spicing in that rice to make for a complete mouthful of that chicken dhoni biryani. I like the bits of chicken that are on the bone. They're softer, also have a little more fat. I think time now to taste that mutton biryani. Of course, I also have the chili chicken here, which Rajiv said is perfect on a cold day. And then there's the mutton liver and also the mutton dry. But I suspect if I taste them first, it will taint my palate. So therefore, we're going to taste that mutton biryani, that mutton dhoni biryani. Hoge bharta hai, steam bharta hai, olegenda. Tells you it's a hot biryani, a busy, busy biryani. Get a piece of meat as well. I don't know if the camera can see this, but if you look at the color of the rice, although the spicing is identical, the chicken biryani is lighter as opposed to the slightly deeper color of this mutton biryani. And I think that's the flavor, and I think that's the character that the mutton brings to that biryani. That is akin to meeting a long lost friend. When you haven't met somebody in ages, and you see that person, and you don't just see that person, but you embrace that person with all your love, with all your heart. That's the feeling that I'm experiencing now as I taste this mutton dhoni biryani after months, nearly a year. The meat is moist and pink, has a bit of a bite. The rice that I'm tasting in that mutton biryani has a certain smokiness to its flavor. It's the same spices that go into the chicken biryani that go into the mutton biryani as well. But I think here, the character of the meat with the bones and the fat takes over. It goes to round off the hard, spicy edges of the biryani. I can taste the flavor of some of that fenugreek. I'm enjoying this biryani. That's the kalua or the stone flour, one of the spices that goes into the making of this biryani here. And there's also some of the other spices here. So this is the marat mogu. That is a typical ingredient in a military style biryani. And the family finds its ancestry in the Marathas. And that's why Shivaji Military Hotel. So therefore also ingredients like this marat mogu. I want to taste that mutton biryani rice alongside some of that chicken biryani rice. Maybe have a bit of the yogurt before that, just to cleanse my palate. Let's go for that chicken biryani rice first. You can definitely feel the aggression of the spices more in that chicken biryani rice. The spicing of the green chili, the aggressive warmth of the hard spices, the freshness of the coriander, some mint. That's what you're tasting in that chicken biryani rice. Now when it comes to the mutton biryani rice, there's also peas that go into the biryani here. The flavors are more rounded, and that's thanks entirely to the character of the meat. So if you like to spice things up when it comes to your mutton biryani, I think that's also where you will find that sherwa handy. That's not your typical sherwa, it's basically the gravy that I see in that liver masala, which perhaps is also an indication of the fact that we should move on to other things around the periphery of our biryani. Oh, I love the green masala in this. I think the onions, the mint, the coriander. I think next we will go to that chili chicken. This is not your Chinese style chili chicken. This is your Nati style chili chicken with tons of green chili. I'm already sweating at the back of my head. Not a pretty sight, but I'm sure after tasting this chili chicken, I'm going to be dripping buckets of sweat. That chicken is nice and moist. You know, when you break into your chicken, you want to see that chicken moist. You don't want to see that chicken dry and fibrous and stringy. That green chili spice, nipped with that garlic, Well, that's a delicious chili chicken. What I like about the sauce is that it's slightly viscous, slightly thick, without coming together in a congealed mess, which also helps in coating every bit of the chicken. I think they're also particular about the cuts of meat that go into the making of the various dishes. So for example, here I can definitely find a lot more cartilage. I guess that's the sort that makes for an enjoyable chew as you take in the heat of that chili gravy. And out here you also have plenty of the chili seeds, which gives that dish its punch. Go for some more of that chicken biryani rice, and let's see what that lemon has to contribute to the biryani. I find the acidity of the lemon a tad overpowering, but if you've tasted too much chili, I think that lemon can provide some respite. I think let's move on next to that mutton dry. I like the deep roasted masala here. There's plenty of onions and also I think some pepper that finds its way into that dish. That pepper is beginning to make its effect felt. My mouth is on fire, but that makes for a tasty masala. I think I'm going to call for the relief of some of that biryani rice. My sinuses are opening up thanks to the spicing of this biryani. But that's the sort of wicked pleasure that you derive from tasting food that is spicy but extremely flavorful. More of that cucumber to quell that fire in my mouth. I'm now sweating on my forehead too. This gives you a sense of how spicy things have gotten here. I think time now to taste that mutton liver. I'm going to go for a piece of the liver that's been submerged in that gravy. We've already tasted that gravy, but now it's time to taste the liver with some of the peas, with that vatana. I love the freshness of the mint and the coriander in this dish. So this is a dish that has plenty of the green masala, and that's what you're tasting. You're tasting the freshness of those ingredients juxtaposed against the meaty, deep flavors of the liver. And that liver is cooked just right. When you're tasting meat liver, if the liver is not cooked well, it can be a little tough. But this is cooked just perfectly well. It has a fragment of a bite before it yields to your taste buds. I love the green masala. Even as I close my meal here, I want to close my meal with the flavor of that mutton donne biryani being the last thing that I taste on my palate. Every time I tell myself I should get a bone pick the next time I step out to a non-vegetarian restaurant, and every time I forget this, and therefore I have to struggle with pulling that marrow out of that bone. And sometimes the things that you can't have is what you crave the most. When I stepped out today on a cold rainy afternoon to savor this biryani, I was quite excited. I've tasted hundreds of biryanis, but today I was feeling that tinge of excitement. That excitement that you feel when you're about to meet somebody that you haven't met in a long time. That pang of nervousness that you feel. You don't know how that friend is going to receive you. That's exactly the tinge of nervousness and excitement with which I set out this afternoon to taste this biryani. But one bite of the donne biryani here was the sort that took me right back to the last time I savored these dishes here. And I think that's what brings all these people behind us who are waiting patiently to savor that biryani fix after months. I must also commend the brothers Rajiv and Lokesh for holding out for all these months. They could have very easily opened this establishment months ago and not lost any business. But they decided on their own volition to hold back dine-in until they felt the situation was relatively better. So although they may have lost business in the last few months, I think in my eyes, and with all their regulars, I'm sure they've earned tremendous amount of goodwill for this noble gesture. I would urge you, when you revisit Shivaji Military Hotel, to try and adhere to some of the protocols that the brothers are trying hard to encourage amongst their patrons. Because at the end of the day, it's up to us, each one of us, to collectively ensure that we are all safe. Well, I've enjoyed my Dhone Biryani and that mutton fry and that liver and that paya and also that chili chicken here at Shivaji Military Hotel. I hope you've enjoyed this episode too. And until the next time, stay safe, stay very, very safe, and happy eating. If you'd like to support the work that we do at Food Lovers TV, do consider joining our membership community on YouTube by hitting the join button below or on the homepage. You could pledge a nominal sum and receive special privileges like behind the scenes footage, shoot updates, access to live Q&As, and a lot more. You could support us on a Patreon page as well. For more info, check out the links in the description below. If you like this video, don't forget to subscribe, like, share, and leave a comment below. Happy eating!